In search of solitude, 27-year-old Robyn Davidson trekked across the West Australian desert with four camels and a dog named Diggity. At the end of that 2,700-kilometre journey, she was horrified to discover she'd become a global celebrity. The experience spawned a best-selling memoir, Tracks, which became a feature film starring Mia Wasikowska and Adam Driver.
I'm so alone.
We all are.
Four decades and as many books later, 73-year-old Robyn says she's still restless.
I'm certainly nomadic. Maybe I've got ADHD. I don't know. Look, this is just my life. It's how it's turned out.
Obviously, you became known as the Camel Lady. What did you make of that nickname?
Patronising, I guess. If a bloke had done it, I doubt that he'd be Camel Gentleman. But now I think, it's not so bad. If I'm a Camel Lady, I'm a Camel Lady.
In her new memoir, Robyn explores the impact of her mother's death.
I think the process of thinking about her and thinking about the past and writing the book has made me realise that we were very fond of each other. And that's a nice thing to know. Because prior to that, it was like she was dead to me, literally.
You obviously have learnt more about her depression.
Mm.
Can you tell me about that?
I was very aware of it as a child. It was awful. She was physically depleted, sort of drooping, weeping all the time, moving slowly. But I do remember very clearly one day she'd come back from seeing a psychiatrist and she said, "The doctor told me that I should be happy. I've got a husband and two beautiful children. I should be happy." And I knew, with all of my 10 years on this planet, how utterly unjust that was.
Whether someone is here or not, they can still be in our lives.
Mm.
What role has your mum played in your life?
I was thinking about her again for the first time in my 40s when I started the book. It was as if I were being haunted by her. And that force wanted me to speak for her because no one else could or would. So I took that as a sort of responsibility. Now I feel that I've done my job.
You've obviously had an unconventional life in many ways.
Yeah, I'd have to admit that.
Always travelling, always moving.
Yeah.
Is that in some way connected with your mum and that relationship?
I think I was possibly born with an intense curiosity about the world. It's also possible that in losing my mum so early and having to look after myself, I had to build myself out of the bits and pieces that were left after her death.
You talk in the book about this 3-year relationship that you had that is public, but you don't name the guy in the book. Why?
From my point of view, that had nothing to do with the reason that he was in the book, which is that it was a very intense and volcanic love affair.
The affair was with the writer Salman Rushdie, who was stabbed last year, leaving him blind in one eye.
What do you make of what's happened?
Pretty much what everyone else thinks, that no writer should have to go through that ever for anything they say. It's appalling.
Have you had other love? Do you have other great love in your life?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, I have. Luckily or unluckily. Well, I've had my share of deep and passionate love affairs, but I suppose the most important of those was my Indian partner, Narendra. We were partners for 20-odd years.
It's still a bit taboo or regarded as undignified to talk about love and sex in the more mature years?
Yeah, why is that?
I don't know. You tell me. You're in your 70s.
I don't know. Well, I think one's sexual life changes over time. Some things become more important than others.
Does it continue?
Oh, yeah, of course. Till the day you drop, it will continue. I can guarantee you that.
I was interested in reading something you'd said about the movie version of Tracks.
Mm-hmm.
You said that you didn't feel that connected to it. Why?
The film, a good film, an honourable film, and I adore Mia. But, you know, ultimately it didn't really have a lot to do with me or much to do with the trip.
How do you reconcile that when they say, oh, I loved the moment when you swam
when
in
you
the pool?
Yeah, or you... when the snake went over your throat. Yeah, I know. A very funny story. When we were travelling with the film, and this woman came up to me afterwards and said, did you really commit suicide at the end of the journey?
Wow.
Yeah.
How did you respond?
I can't remember. I think the jaw hit the ground. I don't know.
Do you ever think about retiring?
Don't even know what it means. Retiring from what? From life? I don't think so.
Work?
I don't want to write anymore. I think this book has been a sort of Pavlov's dog on writing. Just too hard. And I feel also somehow that I've said what I want to say.
If you're talking to a younger person today and you impart some wisdom, what do you say?
Choose freedom. Work out what that means for you and choose freedom. But of course, I'd also say that for young people, it's very different now. And it's so hard for them, and it will be so hard for them because the world is.
Thank you very much, Robyn.
Thank you, Hamish.
Wow, what a wonderful energy she has.
You know, sometimes you get to sit down for an interview and you've learned during it that you're in the presence of someone with such amazing wisdom.
You were quite taken by her.
Oh, 100%. What an amazing life.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, these love affairs, walking across the desert.
Yes.
You know, bought a house with a celebrity. Yeah. You know,
you're
going to
be naughty still in your 70s?
I mean, but sometimes don't you just sort of want to sit there and kind of absorb it all everything they have?
I think what she says too about her mother and those conversations with the psychiatrist, and you think how far we've come with those conversations and how many people watched people that they love go through something that was like undiagnosed or they were given advice like that, which was so unhelpful. And you think, thank goodness that we've come so far in that respect. Mm. But what an amazing way to live your life, you know, the way she's gotten every single squeeze.
Yes.
100%.
Lived it.
So the book is called Unfinished Woman. It's available now in store and online. It's beautiful. Robyn is an absolutely beautiful writer as well as an amazing human. I thoroughly recommend it. If you or anyone you know needs support, Lifeline is on 13 11 14. You can also contact Beyond Blue on 1300 224 636.